North Korea has vowed to become the world's most powerful nuclear and military state as UN sanctions and threats from Donald Trump do nothing to stop the efforts of Kim Jong-un. The hermit state has announced it is hurtling towards a fully fledged nuclear weapons program and will not be stopped by China imposing sanctions which are strangling the nation's economy. North Korea's permanent representative Yoo Song-nam told the UN Security Council Jong-un will not be stopped. Referencing the two-fronts plan, the representative said the North's blueprint for success lies in nuclear power and a strong economy. He said, "Pyongyang will march forward and make great advancement victoriously as world's most powerful nuclear and military state, upholding the line on simultaneous development of the two fronts." Despite both the North's military capabilities and trading options being hit by sanctions, the nation insists it has enough banked to carry on. Yoo said the UN Council is a tool of the US which is terrified by the incredible might of our republic. He also referred to the firing of the intercontinental ballistic missile on November 29 as Great November Event. However, the North Korean said his country would not pose any threat to any country and region unless they were threatened. Yoo claimed there has been no illegal transfer of nuclear weapons, its technology and weapon-grade nuclear materials. The US said it is ready and willing to end the wars of words with North Korea, and will continue to push for talks to end the weapons testing. President Trump's men also warned all options are on the table if the threats continue. U.S. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson said, "The U.S. will use all measures necessary to defend itself. We will meanwhile keep our channels of communication open." He also said there was no chance he would be pushed around by Pyongyang, which is calling for Russia to be at the table during talks, and a number of other demands. He said, "We do not accept any relaxing of the sanctions regime as a precondition of talks. We do not accept a resumption of humanitarian assistance as a precondition of talks. We do not accept a freeze for freeze as a precondition to talks." Russia and China have called on the US to offer ending military exercises with South Korea, in exchange for North Korea ceasing nuclear and missile activities. This was also rejected. But fears are growing around a possible conflict in the region. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres warned the Security Council, "The situation on the Korean Peninsula is the most tense and dangerous peace and security issue in the world today."